Thelifeofelizajoan here, and today is going to be another advice video. If you aren't familiar with my series, it's Big Sister Advice, and today we are going to be talking about how to survive high school. It's a topic that I'm familiar with, and I hope that you guys enjoy this video. So let's get started. First thing that I reckon is something that's very important to survive high school is being organized. You don't want to go to school one day and forget your pencil case or your planner or whatever that you need for that day. You don't want to go to school and realize you've forgotten it. You need to get organized. That includes your locker, that includes handing in work in time, because that will really help you get through high school. Otherwise it will be kind of stressful. You'll miss out on a lot of class trying to find pens. You'll be a disruption, just putting it out there. Yeah, so I reckon that if you're organized, it really helps you in the long run as well as the short run. By being organized, I mean remembering that you've got everything in your bag that you need for that day, that your locker is maintained and always neat, so you know where everything is. Writing down when a homework piece is due, because that is so important. If you write it down, you'll remember it, and I reckon it's very important. And just if you need extensions with work, talk to your teachers, because they will find out a way of giving you an extension. And if they forgot about it, you can always follow them up. That is, getting organized is something that I was like, I have to do it. I'm in year eight. And so that's something that I've always done, because it helps a lot. I know that some of us like some subjects and some of us don't like some subjects, but that doesn't stop you from putting your 100% in every subject. It really does help. I know it sounds really bossy of me to say it, but it really does help. If you like complain in class, the teachers will get angry at you, and it's just stress that is not needed. So it's very important to go into that class that you may or may not like and just concentrate, take notes, do what the teacher says. For me, it's only 50 minutes. Each period is 50 minutes for me. But it's only that time that you're in that class to just get through it and do your work and concentrate and make sure that you're not distracted by others. That is something that's also very important. Don't be distracted in some subjects. Just show the teachers that you actually want to learn, even though some subjects you may not want to learn, but that's all good. You can put yourself into that class and just learn and have a good time in that class, because you have to make most of it. So make sure you're always putting 100% into every class, because it helps a lot. Something else that's really important is to not let issues that are going on in your life affect your quality of work, because that really isn't good. You don't want to fail a subject just because you are having a bad day. It's not good. You should always, with my last tip, put 100% in every subject. Even if you've had a bad fight with one of your best friends, or even if you have been bullied the last couple of 24 hours, you don't want that to stop you having a good class time and stop you from doing your work. You don't want that to happen, because then that gets you to not pass the subject, and it really isn't good. So if you need advice on anything, about what's going on, always talk to your teachers or your closest friend, because they will help and it will get it off your chest. And it's not a good distraction to have something like, oh my god, I wish I didn't have that fight with my friend, put distraction on your work. So that is something that's also very important. Not a lot of like high schools discuss that, because I don't know why, but I think it is very important. Personally, I think it's very important that you shouldn't let an issue outside of class distract you from your work. When making friends, I suggest that you make friends that are in different friendship groups. I've learned this, that it's very important to have friends in one group, friends in another group, and friends in another group. It really does help. I don't know why. It just does, because you may have had a fight with one of the people in one group and you don't want to hang out with them. And if you don't have any other friends to go to, that's not good, because you always need some friends in your life. So always make sure that you've got heaps of friends in different groups, so you can always go to someone if something's happened. And it's just really helpful, and it will help so much. It helps me a lot. It's just very important. That's it for my advice video. I really hope you enjoyed and you find it helpful sometime in your life. Please give this video a big thumbs up. Please subscribe if you haven't already. And comment down below some requests that I can do for you gorgeous faces. And do you like my new setup? It will be my setup until I figure out where else to put my filming device, because I moved my room around again. So yeah, that's news for me. I hope you guys have an amazing day or night, and I will talk to you guys in my next video. Bye!